It's Rich again. Yeah, we're going to talk about not so much watches, but time. It's because I am into watches, I am into timekeeping and just all the things that we do in order to track time and dates. So I'm just going to talk about that for a little bit and how I think certain ways of how we tell time is absolutely wrong and that it should change. Probably never will, but I can wish. Okay, so first of all, let me just take this off. Okay, you see this right here? It says 9:18 on Monday the 8th. Okay. So that is how most watches work, is that you have the time, the day of the week, and the date. Now on a, do I have one close by? I do not. But on most analog watches, you will have the minute hand and the hour hand and the date, not the day. Then there is the day-date watch, which is like this. Or should I say, this is emulative, I think that's a word, of a day-date analog watch, where you have hour hand, minute hand, weekday, and date. That's called a day-date watch. Pioneered by the original Rolex day-date. Okay, so we know that. Putting this back on. That is easy enough to understand. Where things just get weird is when we talk about time zones and date formatting. So that's what I'm going to get into here. Let me explain to you the right way to write out a date. You might think you know, I bet you don't. Now, the North American version of writing out, like, the date is month, day, year. So today, as I record this, is May 8, 2023, which is written out in America as 5-8-2023, or just 5-8-23. If you're over in Europe, on the other hand, it is day, month, year. So that is written as, and I have to actually think about this because it's so not uncommon to me, is 8-5-2023. So that is day, month, year, and we do month, day, year. Both of them are wrong. What it should be written as is year, month, day. You might think that's weird. It's not. It's not. And I'll tell you exactly why. Because on a computer, like if you're in a spreadsheet or something like that, if you write it as 4-digit year, 2-digit month, 2-digit day, you can sort numerically. And it's easy. So if you write it, the date as 2023, 0508, year, month, day. It always works. You can always sort. But of course, we're human, so we like to see letters. If you were writing it the human way, you change the month in the middle to a 3 alpha character. Three alpha characters. So it would be 2023 May 8. I have to keep looking at my watch just so I don't get my numbers screwed up. I might have screwed up already, but I don't think I did. So if you're writing it as that for humans, so you have numeric year, alpha month, numeric day. That always works for humans. One time when I went into an optometrist office, you know, I'd get my glasses and what it, well, not to get my glasses, my eye exam. And I wrote out the date. I make a habit of doing this. I wrote it as year, alpha month, day. And the guy actually came back and says, hey, did you serve in the military? I'm like, no, I didn't. But he recognized it. And he says, hey, I know this. I said, yeah, that's how we used to write it back in the service. Because it makes total sense. It absolutely makes sense. Why does it make total sense with the alpha in the middle? Because there is absolutely no confusion as to what you are reading for a date. Zero. Zero confusion. Here's why. You got a four-digit year at the front on the left. Okay, so four-digit year. You know that is the year. You never abbreviate the year, ever. As in, you never write it as two digits. Always four. Always four. So when you look at it, you say, oh, okay. So we have 2023. I know that. Three alpha characters in the middle. In this case, M-A-Y for May. There's no confusing, that is the month. And when you have the four-digit year at the front and a three alpha character in the middle, there is no question that at the tail must be the day. It eliminates all confusion completely. That is why it is the proper way to write a date. So, and if you get into the habit of doing that, it's fantastic. And the great thing about it is that you don't have to relearn anything. If you just remember, okay, year, month, day, yeah, okay, I can do that. And if there's any form you ever have to fill out where it allows you, as in written by hand, where it allows you to write the date in a format of your choosing, as in it doesn't have the predefined little boxes, whatever, you know, you got your little pen here and you're going to write out the date, do it as year, alpha, month, day. And how does that eliminate confusion instead of making it all digits? Because some people go dyslexic. They have moments of dyslexia. Some people are hardcore, what I call hardcore dyslexics, where they always jumble numbers up. And then there's some people that sometimes encounter a number jumble in the mind. So what happens there is that if I wrote it as, okay, so it's, you know, May 8, 2023. So if I say 2023-5-8, you know somebody is going to jumble that as to 8-5. You know they're going to do it. So that is what, instead of May 8, it would be August 5. In their mind, just, they have a moment of dyslexia, and they're like, oh, I got it wrong. But if you, in the middle, you always write it as the three alpha month. So it would be M-A-Y. They're like, okay, again, zero confusion. None whatsoever. And let's just say if I flipped it, okay, and I say, to use an alternate date as the example. So instead of May 5, I want to write August. That would be 2023 A-U-G 5. So it's like, okay, so if I want August 5, that is how I would write that. So again, you look at it, there is no confusing M-A-Y from A-U-G. None. It is a fantastic way to do it. Now back to the computer for a moment. If you always write it out, if you write it for computers instead of for humans, that is when you do everything 100% numerically, and you always add the leading zero. So for example, on May 8, where you don't write 2023 5 8, no, 2023 0 5 0 8, you have the leading zero. Because in the way that computers work, when it sorts everything, then you can sort. So what happens is that every single date is the exact length, and that's how it makes its sorting very easy. So if you were doing this in a spreadsheet like Excel or something like that, that's less you have to do to accommodate for sorting by date. It's very easy for the computer to do that. So if you have it as the, how many characters is that? Four, five, eight characters. Every single date is eight numeric characters. Absolutely works. Now I'm going to talk about time. Okay. Let me talk about time zones first. There is a reason why pilots the world over do not honor time zones. They don't. Every single flight schedule, as far as I am aware, all of them are UTC. Every single one of them. Because it eliminates confusion. They say, okay, we are all... It's the same reason that all aircraft designations are using the American, Latin, whatever you call it, alphabet. Because it's 26 characters. Every craft, regardless of language, has, if it's a registered aircraft, unless I'm wrong, and if I am, tell me. But as far as I know, every aircraft has alphanumeric using the standard 26 alpha characters and 10 numeric characters, as in 0 through 9. Okay, so we have that. But anyway, the time thing, right? So they all use UTC because it is far easier and far more efficient for them to schedule flights using that clock. That is what they use. I hate time zones. I've always hated time zones. Everyone hates time zones. And I'm also not a fan of daylight savings, which we have to do in the United States for most of the... Is it most or all of the country? I think most. Where I am, I'm in the central time zone. And twice a year, I gotta change the time here. Now, I know some people would say, oh, well, just use your phone. It automatically adjusts for you. We should not have to adjust at all. Okay, anyway, let me do time zones first and then daylight savings. I can't stand time zones. It's just having to accommodate for times, even in this country. So I've got four that I have to deal with in the contiguous United States. You've got, I think, if I remember them correctly, Eastern, Central, Mountain, Pacific. I think that's what it is. There might be another one for way over Alaska and Hawaii. I don't know. I'm pretty sure that's the... I don't know anyone over there. So I only have to deal with those four. And periodically, the ones that I have to deal with the most are Eastern, in addition to Central, are Eastern and Pacific, I think. Again, I'll review this. If I leave this in here, I think I got it right, but if you see like a jump at it, that's me getting around an error. Because it's tough to remember all this crap. It is absolutely tough. Right. I don't think time zones should exist. I really don't. I think every single one of them, gone forever. Everyone, UTC. Everybody. It would make so much more sense just to do that and say, okay, we are not doing zones anymore. We're not doing it. We are just going to go by UTC, and that's it. One clock for the world. Like, good. Then you never have to reset your watch, except, you know, if you want to synchronize it. That's the only time you ever have to reset your watch after that, is for synchronization. It would make it easier, not only for watches, but also for smartphones, for computers, for everything, just to not have all this time zone crap to deal with. And anyone that tells me, well, there's reasons we have legit... I don't care. Get rid of it. Daylight savings? Oh, God. That has been a bone of contention, at least in the United States, for a very long time. People just want it gone. There was a point, I don't know if this is the case anymore, where the state of Indiana had three time zones, which means three daylight savings changes in one state. I think they're down to two now, I think, maybe. Can you imagine that one state, one United State, having three time zones, and then three daylight savings changes every year? How bad would it have been to live right next to a border area within the state where it says, okay, over here it's 7 o'clock, over here it's 6 o'clock, yeah, but over there it's 5 o'clock. Dumb. Absolutely dumb. The state of Florida wanted to, and it went all the way to a congressional level. I don't know if they ever passed it. They wanted to go to to get rid of time zones in the state of Florida altogether and say, we just want to be in daylight savings time all the time because of where the state is situated on the planet. They had legitimate reasons for it. And as far as I know, it's up in Congress right now. I don't know if it ever passed, but... The standard reason that people give for, as in the argument for daylight savings change, is that, oh, okay, well, when we have children standing at the bus stop every year, that those two times a year, when the time zone changes, when the daylight savings time is on or off, that means the children are always standing in where there's daylight out. So they're never standing in the dark. Is that a good reason to keep daylight savings time? No, it's not. Am I saying to put kids in the dark? No, I'm not saying that either. I'm saying if it's that much of an issue, if it is that much of an issue, have the schools change their hours twice a year. How hard would it be to do that? Not hard at all. Honestly, not hard at all. They say, okay, well, we usually start school at 7 a.m. at this time of the year, but here we started at 8 a.m. or 6, or however they want to do it. Now, some people would argue and say, well, then that makes it difficult because parents have to reschedule their lives to get around their children's school's hours. I say, would it really be that much of an adjustment? Would it really be? I'm not so sure about that. But right now, that is the only argument for daylight savings time, is don't let kids stand in the dark at a bus stop. Have the daylight savings time. But then I say, get rid of the daylight savings time. Have the schools just readjust their hours twice a year. Am I wrong? I might be. You can... Listen, if you want to tell me, I can take it. I can take it. But I'm like, so that only reason is, okay, that is why we have daylight savings time in the United States. I'm like, no, that's not, that, if it were more than one reason, some people, and there's other people say, well, for people that commute to work, it's nicer. It's like, well, okay, so no, it's not. Because that means for about half of the year, you've got the sun beaming in your face if you're driving east to work. And then for the other half of the year, the sun's not in your face. So why not just have the sun not in your face all the time when driving eastward to work? Or when driving, if after work, east to go home, depending on what direction you drive to get to work. I don't see the point of daylight savings time. I just don't. Make it gone. And what clock should we go by? The same one that the pilots go by, UTC. Make everything UTC. It would just be better. So just to recap, right. For the date, which you can do now, is that if you write it out by hand, 4-digit year, 3 alpha character month, and numeric day. For computers, same thing, except 4-digit year, 2-digit month, 2-digit day. And you can separate by hyphens or periods if you want to. That makes sense. As far as time zones are concerned, I can't stand them. Get rid of them. Daylight savings time, same thing. Get rid of it. I can't stand it. See you later.